Today, we will be looking at exponents of terms in algebra. Exponents shows how many times a number or variable multiplies itself. Example, 4 times 4 equals 4 squared, which is equal to 16. So this is the exponent, and the number here is the base. Laws of exponents. Exponents are governed by three laws, known as our laws of exponents. Please take note of these laws. They make solving problems easier. Also note that these laws only work when the bases are the same. Law 1. The first law states that A exponent m times A exponent n equals A exponent m plus n. The first law is saying that when terms multiply, provided their bases are the same, you can just add the exponents. Example, a squared times a cubed equals a exponent 2 plus 3, which is equal to a exponent 5. Since we have done multiplication already, this is familiar. Law 2. The second law of exponents states that a exponent m divided by a exponent n equals a exponent m minus n. For the second law, we say that when terms divide, provided the bases are the same, you can simply subtract the exponents. Example, a exponent 5 divided by a exponent 3 equals a exponent 5 minus 3, which is equal to a squared. Here you'll see that we just subtracted the exponents. Note that it is possible to have negative exponents. Example, a exponent 2 divided by a exponent 6 equals a exponent 2 minus 6. This equals a exponent negative 4. Please take note of this. We will mention it again later. Law 3. The third law of exponents states that into parentheses a exponent m all exponent n equals a exponent mn. We are saying that when a number with an exponent is raised to another exponent, we can simply multiply the exponents. Example, into parentheses a squared all cubed equals a exponent 2 by 3. This is equal to a exponent 6. Notice how we just multiplied the 2 and 3. Important rules derived from the laws. Let's look at these common rules of exponent. You don't need to memorize these. Rule 1. Any term or number exponent 0 equals 1. Example, 2 exponent 0 equals 1. B exponent 0 equals 1. 100 exponent 0 equals 1. This is straightforward. We've already seen this in lesson 1. Rule 2. The next important rule is on negative exponents. Negative exponent results in inverse. Therefore, a exponent negative m equals 1 over a exponent m. Example, 2 exponent negative 3 is equal to 1 over 2 exponent 3, which is equal to 1 over 8. So going back to the second example of law 2, where we had a exponent negative 4, we now know we can write it as 1 over a exponent 4. Your ability to move between these two will make the next lesson easier to understand. Rule 3. Another important deduction is when the exponent is a fraction. The denominator of the fraction forming the exponent becomes the root of the term. The rule is A, exponent 1 over m equals the m root of A. Example, 5 exponent 1/3 equals the cubed root of 5. Notice how the 3 became the cubed root. Again, A exponent 1 over 4 equals the 4th root of A. Notice how the 4 became the 4th root. Effect of exponents on negative and positive terms. Now, let's look at some important information about exponents. 1. Any positive number or term remains positive after an exponent operation on it. Example, 5 squared equals positive 25. 2. Any negative number or term remains negative after an odd exponent operation on it. Example, negative 5 cubed equals negative 125. Notice the exponent 3 is an odd number, hence the answer is negative. 3. Any negative number or term becomes positive after an even exponent operation on it. Example, negative 5 squared equals positive 25. Notice the exponent 2 is an even number. Please note that the parentheses is very, very, very important because we are working with exponent on a negative number. I cannot overstress it. Without the parentheses, you will be working with 5, not the negative 5. Try it on a calculator and notice you will get different answers. Exponents on monomials. Now, we look at how to work with exponents on monomials. Example, expand, begin parentheses, negative 2a cubed b, end parentheses, all squared. Note, you can expand and do a normal multiplication on it, but that will not be the best way. The first thing you will notice is that the term is negative and the exponent is even, so the answer will be positive. We learned this earlier. Now we will raise the coefficient to the required exponent. The coefficient here is 2, so we will raise it to the power 2. This will give us 4. Next, we will multiply the exponent of each letter by the 2. So we have A exponent 3 by 2 to get A exponent 6. Then we have B exponent 1 times 2. This gives us B exponent 2. Our final answer is therefore 4a exponent 6 b exponent 2. Exponents on polynomials. Let's move on to exponents on polynomials. Example, 2a plus 3b in parentheses all squared. Remember on the lesson on parentheses, we learned that we work with this like a single number? The best way to solve this is to expand and simplify. We know that 2a plus 3b all squared can be written as 2a plus 3b in parentheses by 2a plus 3b in parentheses. So we multiply the terms in the second parenthesis by the terms in the first. So we have 2a by 2a plus 3b in parenthesis plus 3b by 2a plus 3b, in parenthesis. Now we can further expand and simplify. We have 2a by 2a to get 4a squared, then 2a by 3b to get 6ab. Next we have 3b by 2a to get 6ab. Then we have 3b by 3b to get 9b squared. Now we can add the similar terms. We add 6ab to 6ab to get 12ab. The final answer is therefore 4a squared plus 12ab plus 9b squared. Hope this was easy. Everything was basically being careful and remembering how to multiply. This question is a typical binomial expansion. We will learn an easier way to solve it, but it is still very important to learn this kind of expansion. This brings us to the end of this lesson.
Thanks for watching. Encourage us to post more videos by liking and sharing. Also visit ultimatealgebra.com for more exclusive videos and get our free course that will help you build a strong math foundation and pass your next test easily.